Hello everyone, welcome to Rasayan Academy, my YouTube channel. And guys, now I'm going to start a new playlist which is completely based on name reactions, right? So I'm going to start a new playlist called the 100 Name Reactions, and as promised, I will be discussing the 100 most important reactions for the CSIR examination, and it is definitely going to help you in a lot many other examinations as well. Okay, so the first reaction that we study in today's session is Korey-Chekovsky reaction. It has been asked a lot of times in the CSIR examination as well as in the gate paper. If you see, it is there everywhere, right? So what is the popular Korey-Chekovsky reaction? That is what we are going to discuss today. So it is the reaction of a sulfur elide. So basically, just like we have studied the Wittig reaction, right? What is an elide? Basically, an elide is basically a carbanion. It's just a carbanion which is stabilized by some other heteroatom. It can be sulfur, it can be phosphorus, it can be any other heteroatom, right? So the reaction of a sulfur elide either the dimethyl sulfoxonium elide, which is also called the Korey's elide, or the dimethyl sulfonium elide. Okay, so I'll tell you the difference between these two elides and what are their properties. Okay, these are the two elides which are, you know, most commonly asked, right? So they are going to react with an electrophile such as a carbonyl olefin. So a carbonyl is going to be like this. This is our double bond, this is our imine right over here, NH2 positive, let's say, okay, or thiocarbonyl to offer a corresponding epoxide. So when it is reacting with the carbonyl, it is going to give you epoxide like this, okay, or if there is a alkene like this, it is going to give you a cyclopropane. Or if there is imine, it is going to give you azyridine. So what is azyridine, guys? The three-membered ring containing a nitrogen atom is called the azyridine ring. Or it can be if the starting bond was a carbon sulfur double bond, it is going to give you a thiourane. Now that's the same thing as epoxide, just that oxygen is replaced with sulfur. So this is the whole reaction. Very easy reaction this is, as well as very, very important. So let's now start discussing. So the first thing that I want to tell you over here, that you are going to see two types of elides, and those are like this. This is the first one, which we call the sulfonium elide. What is, yes, you can also, if you are confused in this form, you can also actually write it like this, where there is a positive charge on sulfur and negative charge on carbon. This is going to make the polarity very obvious, that from where it is going to act as a nucleophile, right? So this is our sulfonium elide, okay? And this one right over here, where there is an oxygen, three methyl groups, CH3, CH2 minus, and there is a positive on sulfur. Now this one is the sulfoxonium, because there is an oxygen. It is a sulfoxonium elide, and this one right over here, it is a sulfonium elide. Okay, so there is a difference of just an oxygen, and that difference is going to make a huge difference in the reactivity, how they are reacting. So first of all, guys, we are going to start with understanding that how are these elides getting formed, right? We are going to start with formation. They are very, very, very easy to understand and to remember as well. So guys, let's say we started from dimethyl sulfide. Okay, this is simple dimethyl sulfide, and if we supply a electrophile like this, methyl iodide, any source of methyl, okay, Me positive, it is delta positive, so that it can be attacked by sulfur, and the I minus is going to get removed, okay? So this is what you are getting. This is our sulfonium ion. You can write pH, you can write F, the same thing. It is our sulfonium ion, okay? Trimethyl sulfonium ion. Now, since the positive charge on sulfur has to be stabilized, so a base, when it takes up one of the proton, okay, so all of these methyl groups are exactly same. So the proton can be abstracted from any of these methyl groups. Let's say I'm removing it from here. Okay, so one of the proton has been removed by a base. The base can be our hydroxide. It can be a stronger base as well. Okay, so let's say the proton is being removed and you are getting a negative charge on the CH2 adjacent to sulfur. So this is exactly our elide. Elide is nothing but a carbanion. okay? It is nothing but a carbanion stabilized by a hetero atom like this. So this is our sulfonium elide. I hope that this was very easy. So similarly we are going to now form the sulfoxonium elide. Why? Because just the difference of oxygen is there. So this is our formation of sulfoxonium elide. So as you can easily understand that if we want oxygen, we can start with DMSO, right? We can start with dimethyl sulfoxide over here. So still guys, the sulfur, you know, can actually attack over the methyl and remove the iodide from here. Just this is a simple SN2 attack from sulfur, not from the oxygen, from the sulfur, right? Yes, then what do you see? Again, the sulfur has a positive charge. Again, all of these protons are going to become acidic. Why? Because if it becomes negative, if the proton is being removed by a base, if the negative charge comes over here, the conjugate base is going to be more stabilized. Now, the difference in reactivity of the sulfonium elide and sulfoxonium elide is only because of the stability. This sulfoxonium elide is more stable. Why is it more stable? You can see right from here that the negative charge can actually do resonance. It can actually do resonance with oxygen, which was not possible for the sulfonium elide. Okay, so little bit of difference in reactivity, right? So this is our sulfoxonium elide right over here, and we are going to see some particular examples that how is it reacting. So the first thing first, here we have taken an alpha beta unsaturated ketone system. So we are going to come back on this. First, let's do some reactions. Right. So this is where we have started, that I had shown you something like this. Now I hope that you are clear on this, that you can write a double bond over here between the sulfur and the CH2, because basically CH2 minus was there, sulfur positive was there, right? And it can form a double bond over here. So this is also correct, this form is also correct, whichever suits you. Okay, so if the hetero atom, this is an electrophilic carbon over here connected to a hetero atom, it can be oxygen, it can be CH2 itself, or it can be NH2, sulfur, or let's say this group. So whenever you are having anything like this, the CH2 minus, it is going to, let's study this one through mechanism, it is going to attack over here. And as usual, it is nucleophilic substitution on carbonyl carbon. So the bond is going to open up. Now, when this bond is going to fall back, it does not fall back on this own carbon, right? Because we don't have a leaving group. Rather, if it attacks on this CH2, we are having a good leaving group over here, right? So that is why the oxygen is going to attack over this CH2. And this is what you get. This is our inserted methylene group. So this CH2 has inserted into the carbon oxygen double bond, right? Very easy reaction this is, and this is a very popular reaction, Kore-Chukovsky reaction, right? And see what you get. You get back your DMSO, okay, dimethyl sulfoxide, you are getting it back. Now let's try the same reaction with other lot of other substrates. Okay, so first thing first, let me tell you that when you are having sulfonium elide, okay, and when you are having only a double bond, you are going to get the same reaction for sulfonium and sulfoxonium. Let me just write both of them. This is how I can write it: CH2 minus, S positive, and Me2. So this is our sulfoxonium elide, this is our sulfonium elide. I hope that you are now able to differentiate between them. The thing is, when we are only having one carbonyl molecule, this reactivity is going to be the same. You are going to get the same product. Here it is epoxide formation. Here it is epoxide formation. Similarly, when you have alpha beta unsaturated ketone, there is there the selectivity part comes. So in the alpha beta unsaturated ketone, the sulfonium elide, which is basically not having the oxygen, this one, this is our sulfonium elide. So the sulfonium elide is going to do 1-2 addition. It is going to do 1-2 addition. However, if we have the same reagent, or let's say we are having sulfoxonium elide now, we are having our sulfoxonium elide now. Now the sulfoxonium elide is going to do 1,4 addition. This bond is going to open up like this. When it falls back, it's going to attack over the CH2 again, and you are going to get, rather than epoxide formation, you are going to get cyclopropanation. You are getting cyclopropanation. This is a very, very important concept and a very important difference between these two reagents, that because there is resonance in the sulfoxonium elide, like this, there is resonance in sulfoxonium elide, this elide is a more stable elide as compared to sulfonium elide right over here. So if we are, you know, in the exam, if you are getting a little bit of variety, what can be the variety? The variety can be like this, that in place of sulfonium elide, you are given something like this. Let's say this is our methyl and this is another methyl, and usually what you have is the methyl is negative and this is what you get, CH2 minus, and yes, this is plus. This is your sulfonium elide. I think that you must be clear up till this. This is your sulfonium elide, this is sulfoxonium. Sulfoxonium gives 1,4 addition and sulfonium elide gives 1,2 addition. This must be clear because it's very easy. Right, now the difference is that, let me just clear it out a little bit. Yes, so now the difference is that if you are given a little bit of a variety, what is the variety? Well, the variety can be like this, that on one of the CH2 groups there is, yes, so basically this is your elide and there is a cyanide or there is an ester or let's say any electron withdrawing group. So what is this going to do? Any electron withdrawing group, when it is connected like this, then it is going to make this elide stable. Why? Because it is taking away the electron density either by resonance or by inductive effect. It is going to make this, the elide, a more stable elide or a more stable carbanion. So a more stable one is going to be less reactive. So the less reactive ones are going to always give 1,4 addition. So whenever you see a stable version of sulfur elide, may that be sulfoxonium elide, may that be the elide which is having a electron withdrawing group, it is always going to prefer 1,4 addition. And when you are having the simple sulfonium elide, always 1,2 addition. Always 1,2 addition it is going to give. Right? So in this question that you see, I hope that you are able to see this, that in this question, again we have alpha beta unsaturated ketone. So we start from the alpha beta unsaturated ketone over here, and now we are giving this kind of a stabilized elide. Again, it is just going to do the 1,4 addition. Don't forget to do the 1,4 addition, and this is your product. Okay, this was the carbon which is going to do the nucleophilic attack, so that definitely the CN remains with it. Okay, right, now what about this? Again, alpha beta unsaturated ketone system, okay, or the enone system that we write. So what is this type of elide? That is what you have to determine. Is it a stable one or a non or a simple sulfonium elide? Since we are having electron withdrawing group, this is going to be a stable elide, and a stable elide is going to give us 1,4 addition. So what is the 1,4 addition? 1,4 addition is the addition to the double bond and not to the carbonyl, right? So if it is doing the addition on the double bond, it is going to give us a cyclopropane ring and not the epoxide. Okay, so it is going to give us the cyclopropane ring, which is the major product, and it is the stable product. Okay, so you can remember it like this, that stable elides give stable product. And who is the more stable product? The more stable product is the 1,4 product. Okay, and the less stable elides are going to give the kinetic products, which are the 1,2 products. 1,2 products are the kinetic products. They form faster, and they are only formed by the less stable elide, which is the sulfonium elide right over here, right? Then only we are going to get the epoxide. Okay, so yes, this is what we had talked about over here. Yes, now we have a question. We have a question from December 2015. So guys, it has been asked time and again. So you, if you are practicing more previous year question, you will be able to see by yourself. So again, we are having enone system, but there is one more difference. What is the difference? The difference is the stereochemistry of the reaction. So definitely, what do we have over here? The methyl on the opposite carbon, like this, it is given below the plane deliberately. So if this is below the plane, and we have to do, there are two things that we have to understand. First of all, look at the elide that we have. Is it a stable elide or is it a unstable elide? So this is what you are going to have. First of all, it is only sulfoxonium ion. It is only sulfoxonium ion which is given over here. Now, in the presence of a base which is sodium hydride, the base is going to just take up one of the protons from here, like this. Let's say this is a methyl, let's say this is CH2-. Now the CH2- is going to stabilize the sulfur, right? And this is our elide that we are going to work with. This is our elide which is basically formed. We have to make this elide, okay? Right, so the thing is, now you must be able to understand, it is a sulfoxonium elide, it is a stable elide, and the stable elide is going to give the stable product, which is the 1,4 addition product. 1,4 addition product gives cyclopropanation. It does not give, cyclopropanation is going to be the product and not the epoxide. So we can just cancel out the epoxide just by looking at the elide that we are having. We are having a stable elide, so we are going to form the stable product. So definitely epoxides are not getting formed. Where will the epoxide will be formed? The epoxide will be formed, epoxides form when we have the CH2- SME2. This is our sulfonium elide, simple sulfur elide, right? So, okay. So, now we are having the 1,4 product, but still we are having two options, option A and C, that over here we have to take care of the stereochemistry. If the methyl is below the plane, there has to be the steric hindrance has to be taken care of, and definitely we are going to go with the cyclopropanation above the plane, okay? So, because of steric reasons, we are going to say that this product is going to be more favored. Okay, so in option number A, by looking at the type of elide, by looking at the stereochemistry, I hope that this is clear to all of you, that A is going to be our major product, the cyclopropanation above the plane. What about the second reagent combination? So I hope that all of you remember that lithium in liquid ammonia is going to be used for a single electron transfer mechanism, single electron transfer reduction, which we often call Birch reduction. Okay, we often call it Birch reduction. So what is the lithium going to do? The lithium is going to provide electrons, free electrons in the medium. And let's say, you already know this guys, that whenever, I'll make a video on the Birch reduction as well. So whenever we have the enone system, it is definitely going to give the radical like this, in this manner. The bond is going to open up from here and you are going to get something like this. There is a radical over here, there is a double bond, and it is O minus. This is what you are going to get. Okay, and the methyl is right over here. So this is what you are getting. So even the Birch reduction is first going to transfer the electron to the alkene, which is going to conjugate like this. Okay, so this is what you are getting from the Birch reduction. So similarly, this radical is going to be given one more electron by lithium. It is going to become a negative charge. The negative charge is going to take up a proton from ammonia. It's going to become the methyl group which is present over here, and that has to be above the plane. Why? Because the stereochemistry in this reaction is going to be conserved. Okay, it's not an inversion or something. And the second step is going to be that from ammonia, the proton is being taken away from ammonia like this, okay? Or let's say if you are having butanol, or let's say any other alcohol, usually alcohols are also taken in this medium with Birch reduction. So yes, if you are taking alcohol, this proton can be taken up from the alcohol as well, and finally your product is going to be this one. So everything is taken care of. The Korechakovsky reaction, the more stable elide, going to give the 1,4 product, and then lastly this is the Birch reduction, which is going to give you the 1,4 addition as well. Okay, like this. So our answer is option number 1, confirmed. Okay, so I hope guys that you understood what is Korechakovsky reaction, and I hope that this video is going to help you solve more questions on the same. And thank you so much if you like this video. Also, I would request you that if you are liking the content, please also follow me on Unacademy Plus, or let's say at least come and watch all these special classes, which are free classes. A lot of free content is available on Unacademy by me, and I hope that you all are already joining me over there. And yes, if you like the video, then please subscribe the channel, please share it with your friends as well, and give it a big thumbs up just like this one. Thank you so much, and this is just the beginning. As I am promising, I'm going to bring you 100 name reactions very, very soon, and this is just the first one. Thank you so much, it was really nice. I'm going to see you in the next video. Thank you.